Now joining us for the first time, 13-time UFC veteran, one of the most decorated submission artists in UFC history, Gerald Meerschaert is with us. GM3 on a Sunday, man. Beard looks good. That's a handsome individual classing up the program. How's your Sunday, my man? Good to see you.
Good to see you guys, too. I'm doing great. I can't complain. How are you guys doing?
We're doing well. And, you know, I call you one of the most decorated submission artists in UFC history because you are right now in a six-way tie for sixth all-time in UFC history with 7 submission wins. Ken Flo, you're right there in that tie with GM3, by the way. So he's got a lot of time left to sort of leave you.
We got
to
slow him down. We got to slow him down. Gerald, take it easy, man. Take a fight every, you know, every couple of years. You don't have to fight all the time, you know? It's just...
Yeah, well, apparently I do have to fight all the time, and I got to fight Russians all the time now. So I'm going to try and get in there and submit everybody as fast as I can and move on to the next one.
Damn it.
So you got to the UFC in 2016, and you were 26-8 at the time. Your pro debut was January 13th of 2007. You won with a choke. Wikipedia doesn't even list what type of choke. But I want to sort of take you to January of 2011. You submit Dallas O'Malley, you're 15-4, 7 straight wins. At that point in your career, like, do you think you're on Joe Silva's radar? Are you thinking about the UFC, or is that not, like, at the forefront of your mind at that point in time 10 years ago?
I mean, I was hoping I was, for sure. I forget if it was before or after that, but around that time, I had tried out for the Ultimate Fighter, actually, and, you know, I didn't make it past the first couple screenings or whatever they have, so nothing came of that. But, you know, I figured I'd trained with enough UFC guys before. I kind of had an idea where I was at that time. I didn't think I was ready to make a run at a title, but I definitely think I could compete in the UFC. And it was one of those things where, you know, you put that much work into it already,
right?
You can either just pack up your bags and go home and quit and get a, you know, regular job, or you can stick it out and, you know, make something happen.
Right. Well, because I think when a lot of us were prepping you for the first time and looking at your credentials, I'm trying to figure out why it took so long. So the Sam Alvey fight in 2014, then I'd imagine you thought you were on the cusp at that point in time. And then you went on a run, obviously, thereafter. And that was how you punched the ticket.
Right. Yeah. No, I fought Sam before, too, in 2010. So I think we're 1-1 technically. And then, yeah, for a while, I couldn't get anybody to fight me. I had too big of a record. You know, I wasn't a good matchup for pretty much anyone, obviously. And it came to, like, I took a last minute fight in Tennessee, and then I got the chance to fight for the RFA belt, and that kind of really catapulted me up into the UFC after that.
Right. All right. So real quick, before we get into the picks, a couple more things on you. So $100,000 in bonus money this year. I know the government takes a decent chunk, but we had the Dawkins brothers on last week. And, you know, I talk about bringing these bonuses home to these wives, and I believe you're a young father as well. Like, what is it like as a husband and father to, you know, bring that second bonus check home this year? I'd be like, honey, here's the check. I'll see you in fucking 2 weeks. Like,
yeah, we still got like a fresh out the box baby, so I don't really get to do that. I still got to stay around the house and take care of him and change diapers. But, you know, it's a great thing, obviously, but I will say I pretty much got the contract for the next fight, so I didn't really have time to like fully let it sink in. I'm so focused already on the next fight and like what's coming next. And, you know, my wife is doing very good in her job and she's moving up in the ranks. I have another fight booked. I'm going to try and open a gym here pretty soon. So I've got such a full plate right now. I'm not thinking so much about like how awesome it is so much as like, I'm trying to get all my ducks in a row so I can make this thing work.
Sure. Well, it was a huge win over Mahmoud Muradov back in August. And before we get to the picks, just anything else you can share in terms of the gym and the future? You know, we've obviously seen from afar some of these defections out of Milwaukee, largely because of COVID-19, but any insight for us as to what exactly is on the horizon there?
So it'll probably start early next year. I wanted to do it this fall, actually, but I got booked for a fight right away. And, you know, I would hate to open up a gym and be like, all right, guys, I'm not going to see you for another 6 weeks. So have fun. But,
right.
You know, I'll probably be up in the Heartland area most likely. And, you know, 2-3 days a week to start off with, get a little something built there, like probably mostly be grappling to start off with. And then we'll kind of take it from there and just let it grow organically.
All right, man. Well, it's great to see you and great to have you on the show. And we talk a lot on these airwaves about sort of the offensive submission game and it being kind of a lost art. So we got a lot of respect for you. And you know, Sean Shelby has an absolute submission bias when it comes to handing out bonuses. So I hope they keep coming your way.